What is up and welcome back to my channel for another part of the Sims 3 to Sims 4 series where I am recreating the Sims 3 families and their homes in the Sims 4. So today we are recreating the working friend's household, which I was planning on doing this, but I actually had somebody tell me that was their favorite to play, and so I was like, well, I'm gonna go ahead and make that just for you. But anyways, so the working friend's household consists of four unrelated friends: Tori, Madison, Aisha, and Monica. And their little bio says they have come together to share this house. Madison and Monica are best friends forever. Tori is a best friend wannabe, and Aisha is a tomboy who couldn't care less. So the interesting thing about this family is all members of the household except Aisha have the snob trait. So anyways, right now I'm recreating Tori Kimura. I don't know how to say her last name, but she is described as being serious and as having a desire to be one of the group, by which it is also implied that she is not quite regarded as such, you know, part of the group, although she does share that snob trait with roomies Monica and Madison, with whom she is friends. She's charismatic, her roommates are clumsy and absent-minded, so her value in the household is likely due to her contributions via her natural cook and workaholic traits. Wow, that would make me feel really bad about myself. But she is in the politics career track, so yeah, that's a little bit about Tori. Now we are creating Monica Morris. I just realized that I did not give her my skin overlay, which is why I could not figure out why she didn't look right, which she looks good, don't get me wrong, but there was something off, and I just realized I didn't put a skin overlay on her like I did all the other ones. But anyway, so Monica Morris, she is in the athletic career. It says she wears quite a lot of makeup and her hair is dark red but with dark brown highlights, meaning that she probably dyed it. Obviously, you see me struggle with the makeup. I just could not find any color swatches that looked good on, you know, her dark skin complexion and the way that I was wanting to portray her personality, being that she is very athletic and in the athletic career. I wanted to kind of tone it down a little bit, and I gave her some lipstick, so she's got her eyeliner on, so she's still wearing makeup. She's rocking the red hair, which I thought was kind of going to be a problem at first. I couldn't figure out what to do with her eyebrows because her red eyebrows just stood out. So I kind of toned them back down to brown so we can say she just dyed her hair red and she just didn't dye her eyebrows. I don't know. But anyways, she is best friends with Madison. Based on her bio, she is known as down-to-earth rich girl, even though she has no rich parents, siblings, or other relatives. So now we are recreating her best friend, Madison Van Watson. So it says she is sweet, but perhaps a little immature, considering in The Sims 3 she had the childish trait. Oh my gosh. And while this is the working friend's household, she is the only one that is unemployed, which is interesting, but I think it's because she's just a rich girl. Her biography says the materialistic rich girl. So I think some theories say that, you know, Monica and Madison come from like a rich town and they're besties, and they obviously, you'll see their house, it's bougie, it's really cute, they've got a lot of nice stuff, and I personally think that it's because of Monica and Madison's family, and then obviously Tori and Aisha just come in as roommates and get to enjoy the luxuries of living with two rich Sims, even though they don't have like a ton of money and don't come from like rich family, like they don't have any family in the game. It's just kind of to leave up to your imagination what kind of life they lived. But yeah, I always thought Madison was really cute. Her style was just like very girly, and she's very clumsy and kind of ditzy, and I don't know, I think she'd be like a big personality and a lot of fun to play with. So now we are creating Aisha and Sari, and I think I'm saying that name right. I had to look up how to say Aisha. I was like, Aisha? No, it's Aisha, I think. But anyways, she has no known relatives. However, her name indicates that she might be of Asian or Middle Eastern descent. Her initial job is decoy in the criminal career track, although she would perform better in the law enforcement career based on her trait selection and her skills. But she is described as a tomboy who couldn't care less. So she does not have the snob trait like the rest of her roomies. And I thought she turned out really cute. attitude. I liked her style just because she's just more laid back. And I realized that I don't have as many short hairstyles as I would like. So I'm about to go CC shopping for some more short hairstyles. So she does have a base game hair, which I think turned out cute nonetheless. But anyways, now we are recreating their house, which resides, their house resides at, hold on, let me look. It is 270 Sunnyside Boulevard, which in The Sims 3, y'all know there are the three, they kind of look like apartments, or I call them condos. They remind me of condos, but some people have said they remind them of apartments, but I think they look like condominiums. They're very colorful, and they all are like in a little, they're all three right beside each other, and then there's like a neighborhood pool in the back. So I kind of had to use my imagination a little bit, because at first I wasn't going to put a pool, but in the end you'll see I add a pool, which I'm glad I did. I think it turned out really nice. But anyways, I was kind of worried about this house, which I think this is going to be a lot easier than the other household I'll be doing that lives in these type of apartments, which is the, I think they're called just the roomies household. Their house is a little bit more complicated because they have a crap ton. Like, every single room has a balcony, which is interesting. But yeah, the color scheme of this house, I was kind of like, I don't really know how this is going to turn out. But I think it turned out really good. I'm always impressed with myself. I know, I always feel like I'm bragging on myself when I do these builds. But y'all, I think they turn out so good. I love them. Every time, I think it says a lot, every time you create a family or a house and you want to play with them and you just kind of fall in love with them, I think that's a good sign. And every house that I've recreated from The Sims 3, every household in the house, I have fallen in love with. So yeah, obviously, as I've stated before in the previous videos, I am not being very anal about this house being spot on like The Sims 3. I want to go for the same, you know, floor plan, the layout, but as far as like the color scheme, well, okay, I want the outside color scheme to resemble The Sims 3 as much as possible, but as far as like the interior, I kind of just use my imagination and kind of give it a makeover, kind of like with the Creative Sims, y'all. If y'all are familiar with this household, y'all know that their outfits and hair and everything was just funky. So I feel like I did them a favor. I gave them a makeover. I made them very fancy and not fancy. Oh my gosh. Not luxurious. Stylish. There you go. Stylish. That's the word I was thinking. You go, Carissa. But anyways, yeah, I think their house is really nice. It's big. And I think I made it too big. Which I did the outside, obviously, first. And it matched up to the size that I was going for copying, you know, with the garage and the balcony and everything. It fit perfect. But I think I made it a little bit too wide, as you'll see once I get inside upstairs. There's like a hallway balcony, and I think I made the hallway too wide. It's really supposed to only be a single hall, but I made it really big, so I kind of had to fill that space in, which big houses give me anxiety like this because there's so much freaking space you have to fill up. So don't worry, expect our next video that we recreate in The Sims 3 to Sims 4 series, it's going to be a single sim because I need a smaller house, because this one right here, I worked on it. It only took me one day to finish, but that's literally all I did. It took me probably 4 hours to do this house, which wasn't straight, you know, 4 hours. I would take a break here and there, but oh my gosh, I was determined to get it done. I was on a roll. I was inspired, but it's like these big houses, they just kind of like suck all the life out of you. Like, they kind of drain you. But the bigger the house, you know, once it's over with and it's done, you just feel really good when it turns out, you know, the way you wanted it to. So anyways, their house is, I think it's 3 bedroom. They're really big bedrooms too, especially the downstairs bedroom, which the downstairs bedroom, you could honestly make 2 bedrooms out of it, but in The Sims 3, it was a room that was shared by two of them, which I figured that it was obviously Madison and Monica's room, since they are the two best friends of the household. I imagine that they would share the room together. And in The Sims 3, their bed is only single beds, but it was so big that I was able to, you know, put double beds in. And then upstairs, Tori has her room and Aisha has her own room. But yeah, overall, I think this house turned out really nice. I was going to cut out the floor plan because I usually don't include me struggling with the floor plan, but I forgot. So there you go. You're welcome. But but this one wasn't too hard for me to figure out. And I obviously didn't know what to do with the garage space downstairs because we don't have cars on The Sims 4. You know, I was just going to leave it kind of blank, but it just looked too big of a space to leave empty, so I just plopped in some little fake cars there for our imagination. And as far as the interior of the house, I kept the orangish, you know, hardwood floor that they have, and their walls were actually yellow and painted, and their house was actually one of the nicer houses. It wasn't too funky. It was actually very, very well matched. Like, the color scheme flowed. I was very impressed, but I figured that this house, it just kind of reminds me of, like, an industrial type condominium, you know, with the black, and I don't know. I that's just what the vibe I get from these houses. So I ended up making the wallpaper the brick, and I was going to put like paint in the bedrooms and the bathrooms, but I ended up just putting brick all the way throughout, just because I don't know, I like the vibe it came with. And this house is actually very colorful compared to, you know, my usual tastes. Many of you know that have watched any of my speed builds, I tend to gravitate towards those more neutral and white tones. That's just what I like. But that's why I've been having so much freaking fun recreating these houses, because it's putting me outside my box a little bit and helping me grow as a builder, and I'm experimenting with new stuff. And so I think this house turned out perfect. I think it represents a house full of girls, all of their personalities. I think you can see in the house, obviously it's very nice. It's a very expensive house. I don't remember how much it is. I want to say it's like 200 and something simoleons, 200,000 simoleons, something like that. 268 maybe, I don't remember, but it's very expensive, and it's huge. So like I said, I do believe that this is because of Madison and Monica's wealthy family. So they were blessed enough to have a family that, you know, helped them get this nice place, which I think it's perfect for a hangout spot. They have like a little bar area and the dining room, which I thought was so cute. And obviously upstairs, you'll see I kind of, you know, made it like a little game room type area. So yeah, I definitely see them, even though their description or title is the working friends, I think that makes them sound very serious and very ambitious, which I think they are. They all are very ambitious, except Madison. She doesn't have a job. I don't know what she's doing with her life, but I think that they also are, you know, very, very, what's the word I'm looking for? Fun. I feel like that they would be friends with a lot of people because, you know, it's four girls. You know, I see them all having, they're all different personalities. So I imagine them having all types of different friends. And then their friends come over, hang out. I gave them a little game table over there in the living room, as you saw. So yeah, I think this is like the perfect hangout spot. So I think this will be a really fun household to play if you want to, you know, play with some single Sims and throw some parties. I think their house is perfect for that. So their house is available for download on the gallery if you want to download it. It is CC free, but of course I do kind of include probably all of the packs, something from all of the packs. I don't limit myself. I'm sorry. It's hard to limit myself when I'm trying to go outside the box and be creative. Y'all know what I'm saying? But anyways, yeah, I think that their little bar area, like, goals. Okay, this house reminds me of a college student's house. Okay, throwback to when I was in college and I was in a sorority, you know, with my sisters, and this reminds me of like our dream house. You know, it would be so much fun to, you know, come hang out here and party here and relax here. So yeah, I definitely see them being young adults, you know, just fresh out of college. This would be really fun to, oh my gosh, yes. Okay, when we get the university expansion pack, you best believe I'm gonna be playing with this household, and we're gonna take this house and we're gonna plop it in hopefully whatever sim state, sim city, whatever world we get that comes with university. It'd be really fun to play with them and have them, like, obviously, because, like I said, Madison and Monica are rich, so, you know, they've got these friends and they're going to college. I just see them more like college students. I guess because they're so young and they're all single and they're all starting out and their house is just so, like, young and fresh. I don't know. I just think that'd be a fun idea. I'm so anxious and excited for the next pack that we're going to get, expansion, which I know we're probably going to get a game pack. I don't think university would be a game pack. I would hope that they give it to us as an expansion, but I'm excited to see what stuff pack we get next, what, you know, game pack we get next, and then, of course, I'm so freaking excited for university. I did not think that Get Famous was a pack that I wanted. I was honestly kind of hoping that our next expansion pack would be, university, but when they announced Get Famous, I was shook. I didn't know it's something that I wanted so bad, but I do, and I'm so freaking excited for it. I have been watching the live streams. I don't ever get to watch the live streams when they're live. I start, but it's usually when I'm at work, so when I get home and I get ready to go to bed, I'll watch it. So I just caught up on the last one, which we talked about Fame and Reputation, which, can we just, oh my, like, the detail. There is so much in this pack that is unbelievable. I think it's going to be so much fun to play. I'm so excited. I can't believe that we have, it's next week. It comes out next week. Like in a week. I'm freaking out, y'all. I'm so excited. I have so much to do. So much to do because obviously I'm going to have a LP for Get Famous. And I've seen some people on Twitter asking, are y'all's, you know, Get Famous LP, is it going to be a mini LP or is it going to be a full LP? I think mine's going to be a full LP just because I think there's so much content that I don't know if I could, you know, squeeze it into a mini LP. So it's going to be a full-on LP. I think it comes out Thursday. Well, for me, I looked at my time zone. It comes out, I think, at 11. I think it'll be 11 p.m. that it comes out, which is right before midnight, obviously, of the 16th. So I think mine comes out the 15th. I've already pre-ordered it, so anyways, here's my dilemma with that. Okay. I babysit on Fridays. I work Monday through Thursday, and I babysit on Fridays. I wake up at 4 o'clock, and I'm at my mom's to babysit my little cousins and my goddaughters at 5 o'clock. That's what time I get there. So from 5 to 3:30, I'm babysitting a 3-year-old and a 8-month-old. So I don't have time to record. There's absolutely no way in hell. This just ain't happening. Yeah, they take naps, but it's never at the same time. So I'm like, what am I going to do? Because I've got to play Get Famous. Like, it comes out. I've got to be on it. I've got to have my LP up the Friday it comes out. Y'all already know I'm going to be ahead of the game. So here's my game plan. Are y'all ready? Don't judge me. I'm going to pull an all-nighter, even though I'm waking up and babysitting, like, bad little kids, which are not bad, but, you know, if any of you are moms or you have siblings and you know what I'm talking about, they drain you. But I'm pulling an all-nighter, and I can't go home because I don't have any privacy, so I'm staying at work until I'm staying at work and in my office all night long, not kidding, and playing Get Famous and recording our Let's Play. That's my plan, so I'm excited about it. Not really. It's probably going to be really miserable, but I've got to get it done. But I'm excited, so it's okay, right? Anyways, here we are in the bedrooms, which is my favorite parts of this house, probably. I love Monica and Madison's bedroom here. So this side of the room is going to be Madison's. I made it a little bit more, like, girly, I guess you would say, and I love how I divided the room. See, it's a really big room, and you could make it two bedrooms because they're huge, but I wanted to copy The Sims 3, how they shared a room, so I used those wall dividers, which in The Sims 3, they had the little dividers, but it was not that cute, okay? They didn't have, like, the curtains to, you know, section it off, so I thought that was a really good idea, and I'm proud of myself for that when I got creative there. But anyways, yeah, so Madison, like, doesn't have a job or anything, so I really wanted to portray their personalities in their bedrooms, and she's just, like, very materialistic, they say, so I gave her, you know, a nice little makeup area. I toyed around with giving her, like, a seating area, maybe a makeup area, but instead I just put her a little desk there with a bookshelf. So, you know, whatever she decided to do with her life, if she wanted a job, there's a little desk area for her, or, you know, Monica to use, obviously, on her side of the room. And since Monica is the more sporty, friend of the group. Well, actually, Aisha's actually sporty, too. Yeah, Aisha is sporty. She's a tomboy. But since Monica is in the athletic career, I wanted her side of the room to portray that side of her personality. So above her bed, I put the little trophies because I just imagine that she, you know, maybe played sports throughout high school and college, and she won a lot of trophies. So I wanted to show that off. I didn't make it like super girly or anything like that. Didn't want to go for that vibe with her just because, well, she does wear like a lot of makeup, it said, and she's not the tomboy, but she's just more athletic. So I put like a little team picture there and some trophies, and I don't know, I just tried my hardest to portray their personalities, which I think I did a pretty good job at, if you ask me. And these lights out here under the balcony, which looks so freaking good with the pool, you'll see I did that last, but I'm proud of myself. I got really creative, which you're probably thinking, that's not really creative. I've seen a million people do that. Well, guess what? I've never done it before, so I like it. And I'm proud of myself. So just let me gloat, okay? But anyways, y'all, I'm struggling to finish this voiceover, but we're almost done. We're almost done. Actually, I'm not struggling. It's been pretty easy. I can't believe I'm 20 minutes in, y'all. Usually, I've passed struggling. But yeah, I think their rooms turned out really, really cute. Probably my favorite room is theirs just because of how I divided it. I think it turned out really nice. And then when you go upstairs, there is two bedrooms, and I gave Aisha this room over here. And since she is more tomboyish, I didn't want to give her a super girly room. So you'll see I kind of struggled with like her bed swatch and the color scheme and her personality. She is sporty, and she also is creative, which when I started when I started with her room, I didn't know she was creative, but I had some extra space, didn't know what I wanted to put there, so I was like, you know what, let's just give her a piano or something. Turns out she's creative, so it worked, so go me. But yeah, I think her room is really cute because, you know, usually it's not girly, you know. I would typically make this bedroom for, you know, a married family sim couple, because I don't want my married sims to have like super girly bedrooms because I feel like the husband would not appreciate all the pink and girliness. But I just like how she's more chill and calm and, you know, not so out there and glamorous as her roommate. So I think out of all of the sims in this household, I think Aisha is my favorite. She thinks she was always my favorite, just because she could care less about, you know, she's not a snob either, which that's great. Nobody likes a snob. But anyways, I think her room turned out nice. And then once I get to Tori's room, her room was a lot of fun too, since she is the best friend wannabe. I've always kind of felt bad for her, just because, I don't know, I feel like she tries hard to fit in and be their friend, but she's kind of left out, you know, when you're around two people that are like thick as thieves and they're super freaking close and you just kind of feel like you're third wheeling. That's Tori. That's how I feel Tori feels. That's how I feel Tori feels. Okay, that makes sense. But her room was a lot of fun. I just imagined that I gave her the bigger room, like I said, because I feel kind of bad for her. I feel like she would kind of retreat to her room, you know, when she got her feelings hurt because they were kind of trying to leave her out or they didn't invite her shopping. I don't know. But she is in the politics career, so I did give her like a desk area that looked like, you know, she is working, a little work area, put some files there. I gave her a little podium so she can practice her speeches. So I really, really worked hard in trying to portray their careers and their interests and everything in their bedrooms. I also ended up giving her a little makeup desk area just because, well, I don't really have a reason. I just needed to fill the space, but I think their room turned out really, really nice. And yeah, that's about it. I was trying to drag it out so I could talk about all the other rooms, but I'm failing at that. But anyways, as you'll see, the hallway and the upstairs balcony area, it's big, and I really was thinking about making it smaller, but then I didn't want to mess with their rooms and the exterior of the house because I think it just looks so nice. So I kind of just had to use the space. I was going to make it like a little loft area and put some couches up there, but I didn't really like the way that looked. So I put, you know, the little not ping pong table, what is it called? Foosball, there you go. Foosball table and the darts and little seating area. And you know what I want in The Sims 4? I want a pool table. I want some more gaming tables, like a ping pong table. Maybe we'll get that with university. I know that, I think we got that with university. We got a pool table with The Sims 2 University, and then there was that ping pong table. Was it beer pong or was it ping pong? I don't remember, in The Sims 3, but I think that's something that I would really like to see. You know, I know that's something I would really like to see in The Sims 4. So I think that, yeah, we'll definitely probably have those when it comes to university, hopefully. I could be completely wrong, though. They tend to surprise me with what they include in our packs. And also, over there in the other corner, I ended up making that their little laundry area. And originally, I was going to put the laundry downstairs and probably like a garage area or something. But I had all this extra space upstairs in these balconies and lofts. It just made sense to put it up there, which I think it turned out really nice. I just love how open this house is, how big it is. But I think I did a good decent job at cluttering it and making it, you know, lived in but not too cluttered. So yeah, but also I had mentioned and I had asked you guys what you thought of me taking these houses and the Sims and creating a save file for, you know, all my recreations of the Sims 3 families. And a lot of you were like, yes, I download it for sure. But I don't know if I'm going to do it because I was thinking, and with some of these houses, it's like I might have to use the same lot because we're limited to the size of our lots, and some of these houses are big, you know? And also, I don't plan on stopping at Sunset Valley. I love doing this so much. It's been so much fun, I kid you not, that I'm honestly thinking about doing, you know, Riverview, or was it Riverview? What was that town called? I don't remember. Oops, when you think you know what you're talking about, but you don't, that might be it. But also like Appaloosa Plains and Twinbrook and, you know, even doing some apartments for the Bridgeport Sims, you know, I don't know. I think it's so much fun to recreate these Sims that already have these stories. So yeah, I may be doing that. So I don't know if we'll have a save file, but you know, obviously they're all going to be available for you to download. And I'm sorry again, thankfully I haven't seen anybody complain about my Sims being covered in CC, and then of course me not linking the CC, which I've explained. I have my CC merged, so it's hard for me to, you know, do that. But go follow my CC Tumblr and you will find everything. If not, just, you know, download them, give them a makeover, and it's still same features, same Sims, just, you know, fix them up how you please. But anyways, y'all, this video is wrapping up, so I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, be sure to give it a big thumbs up. Comment what family you would like to see next. Subscribe if you have not, and I will talk to y'all later. Bye!